What's up, money growers? Jacob back here with another video. Hope you guys are all doing great. Hope you have more money today than you did yesterday. And we're gonna be talking about something today in this video that is pretty cool when it comes to American Express and something unique that they offer, and that is charge cards. So we're gonna be comparing two of arguably their most popular charge cards, at least on the personal side. So we're gonna be comparing the Platinum card today versus the Gold card. So we have American Express versus American Express. So if you're looking at getting one of these two, we're gonna break down the benefits. They have plenty of benefits for both. But you're going to see why the Platinum is a little bit more of the premier card that they like to push. So we're going to go ahead and dive into that today. So guys, go ahead and subscribe. And if you have one or both of these cards, I definitely want to hear about it down below in the comments section. Please help out the other people that are new to the world of credit, because there's always a lot to talk about in credit. It always seems to be changing and people's experiences differ greatly. It's like your mileage may vary, sometimes a lot. So let's go ahead and jump into the video here talking about this. Now, when it comes to the Platinum card versus the charge card, now, these are not credit cards, all right? The big difference between these is that with charge cards, you typically have to pay your balance in full. You don't get, like, you know, the same time window you do with a credit card. Now, the thing with charge cards they like, and they often promote, is the fact they don't have any, they don't have, like, a preset spending limit on them. That doesn't mean you can just spend, like, whatever the hell you want. But they don't have a preset spending limit on them. So you generally have to pay the balance in full each month. Now, one of the things that they're doing with American Express with their charge cards is they're basically becoming, like, a hybrid with credit cards. Because I think almost all of them have a, you know, the ability now where you can pay over time with these cards. So they really do become, like, a credit card in that sense, but they do allow you to carry a balance. So they've kind of gone from, even talking to the reps on the phone, they're like, yeah, like the charge cards, like, you know, they've always been marketed as charge cards. That's what people know them as, but they are like a hybrid with a credit card. So similar concept, but these are two of the more popular ones from American Express, at least on the personal side. Now, if you're looking at this, they often do charge an annual fee, and you're gonna see that the Platinum card annual fees, we get towards the end, we'll talk the fees, is definitely higher than the Gold card annual fee, but the Platinum card does offer a hell of a lot of benefits, and you can see why you know, they do offer, why it is one of these popular cards that they have. Especially you get access to those Centurion lounges in the airports. Man, that's nice with the Platinum card. So with American Express, though, you are gonna need to have a good to excellent credit score to qualify for a charge card. American Express typically has a little bit higher standard for credit scores they like people to have. One good thing, though, is they're not really inquiry sensitive. So if you've had, you know, quite a few hard inquiries lately on your credit report, American Express doesn't seem to really be affected by that a whole lot. So that can be very good news for lots of people. Also, the AmEx Gold, you can get it in rose gold, right? Right down here in the bottom right, you get in rose gold color. So some people think that's prettier and they can get it in that color if you want. It doesn't change anything about the card. It's just a slightly different color. Now, another thing with American Express you guys want to know, and I'll tell you just from my own experience, is a lot of what I was seeing online when you apply with American Express is that they were going to give you a hard inquiry on Experian. That did happen to me when I applied on the personal side. I got a hard inquiry on Experian, but then 2 days later, I also got a hard inquiry on TransUnion. So I got double hard pulled when I applied for American Express. But once you're in the system and you apply for other personal credit cards with them, those are all going to be soft inquiries. And same thing for credit limit increase. It's a soft inquiry once you're in their system. Now, when you apply on the business side, when I spoke to a rep, she said, hey, it could be a soft pull. It could be a hard inquiry from, you know, one of the personal credit bureaus. When I applied for a business credit card, I got no hard inquiry, none. So I just needed, really, I got hit with the inquiries when I got in on the personal side. But now on the personal and business side, I really probably won't have any other hard inquiries going forward with American Express. Now, looking at what these cards offer, what they their benefits, right? Rewards, travel, shopping, good to excellent credit. That's the same across the board for both these cards, but you're gonna see the Platinum card definitely leans more towards travel, and the Gold card leans more towards like daily rewards, or you know, like a more of a daily spending card. Now, the sign-up offer, as of the making of this video, because these offers change all the time, you're gonna get 100,000 MR points, membership rewards. That's what it is with American Express. MR points after you spend $6,000 on purchases in your first 6 months of card membership. You get 10 times the points on eligible purchases at restaurants worldwide and when you shop small in the US on up to $25,000 in combined purchases during those first 6 months. So you get 9 additional points on top of the 1 point you earn for these purchases. American Express, lots of people like to use their points for travel. That's ideally what they use them for. You can use them. They don't have cash back, but you can get gift cards. the return on those is not very good. It's not a penny per point. It's like 60% of a penny per point is what it is. But American Express also has a card co-branded with Charles Schwab. You can actually use your MR points to invest with them. That's actually pretty cool. So the gold card we're looking at here, 60,000 MR points after you spend $4,000 on purchases in your first 6 months. They have the APR for pay over time feature, 15.99 to 22.99 variable APR. So like we were saying, you know, usually you have to pay it off in full each month, but they do have that pay over time feature if you decide you want to carry a balance. Now, as we dig into some of the benefits here with these cards, American Express, the Platinum card, 5 times the points on flights that you book directly with airlines with American Express travel, up to $500,000 per year, okay? And you get 5 times the points on prepaid hotels you book with AmEx travel and 1 on everything else. Now, with the gold card, you're gonna get 4 times the points on dining and restaurants, you know, so takeout and delivery, 4 times the points on groceries at supermarkets, so that's said it makes it more of a everyday spending card. And then 3 times the points on flights booked directly with airlines or on AmExTravel.com, and 1 point on everything else. So you do get travel rewards and travel points with the gold card. You get more of them with the platinum card, but said the gold card is designed to be a little bit more of a everyday spending card. So if you're going dining, restaurants, grocery stores, things like that. Now, as we also look at some of what they offer here, right, your Uber Cash, $200 with the Platinum, you get $120 in Uber Cash with the Gold over here, and you get $100 experience credit to use when you stay and you book the hotel collection with American Express Travel. So $100 experience credit. On the Platinum side, you'd have a minimum 2-night stay required to be eligible for the benefit. So again, similar, but a little bit heavier on the Platinum side. And then as we look here at other credits they give you, so the Platinum side, they're gonna give you $200 back in statement credits, which helps bring down that hefty annual fee that they have for this card. So it's $200 back in statement credits each year on select prepaid hotel bookings. So again, heavy for travel. Preferred seating to certain events, cultural events, sporting events, things like that. Then you do have access to like pre-sale tickets and, you know, card member only events like in, you know, some major cities and stuff like that. Now, with the gold card, you're gonna get $120 dining credit and up to $10 in statement credits monthly when you pay at Grubhub, Seamless, and Boxed, enrollment required. Preferred seating also for events, exclusive access also for certain events and things like that. Now, another benefit you're gonna get with the gold, you get your car rental loss and damage insurance. But with the platinum, it's just there's more to come too. $240 digital entertainment credits. You get up to $20 each month, so it can be up to $240 for the year. Now, you get $155 Walmart Plus credit. So use your platinum card to pay for monthly Walmart Plus membership, and you get the full cost back each month on top of that. Now, as you continue with benefits, instead of the platinum, they just keep rolling. So they're gonna give you $300 back each year on eligible Equinox memberships or Equinox Plus when you enroll and use your card. Equinox is an expensive gym membership to have. So, I mean, 300 is nice, but you're paying a pretty penny to have that gym membership. You get 200 per year in statement credits when incidental travel fees on one selected airline are charged to your card. $179 back on your Clear membership when you use your card. $100 in statement credits annually for purchases at Saks Fifth Avenue. So, hey, if you like to shop there, you get $100 in statement credit for that. And as we continue to move, we have even more. So you do get some savings when it comes to international, right, business premium economy seats on more than 25 world-class airlines. So you do have some, you know, benefits there. You also have complimentary premium status for a number of car rental programs. You can receive a statement credit every 4 years after you do your $100, after you apply for global entry for $100, or every 4.5 years of a 5-year membership when you do the TSA pre-check. So again, this is a car that is heavy towards travel benefits, and we're talking more travel here, right? Fine hotels and resorts program. This has an average value of 550 in extras at over 1,100 properties, but you get the daily breakfast for 2. You can check out late at 4 p.m. instead of having to check out like at, you know, 11 a.m. or noon or something like that. And you get $100 experience credit. So I've also heard of some of those things being applied to like some of the spas and things like that at some of these properties. So I think it just varies from hotel to hotel and what they offer. This, of course, is going to give you your car rental loss and damage insurance just like the gold card does. Trip delay and cancellation insurance too, specific events you can attend. And then they have these inner circle points that you can get as well. So you can use these points towards purchases at your higher end stores, right? Neiman Marcus, Last Call, stuff like that. So with all of that, as we go, other ways you can pay with these two cards. So you can do the pay the minimum amount due and use the pay over time feature to carry a balance with interest. Like I said, these are becoming hybrid charge cards and credit cards now. And then same thing if you use Planet to select large purchases and split them into monthly payments with a fixed fee. Same option available on both these cards because both of these are charge cards. They are technically not credit cards. Now, as we go and look at the fees, ha ha ha, this is what people want to know about when we see this. So the annual fee with the Platinum card, all those benefits are not going to come with, you know, a low fee, $695. So in 2022, they raised that. It was $595, now it's $695. Now you see they do offer quite a bit in terms of benefits and statement credits and things like that. So, but obviously not everyone's going to use it. Not everyone's going to use a $100 statement credit for Saks Fifth Avenue or that kind of thing, or the $300 Equinox credit. So you really have to decide for you if that annual fee is worth it. Plus, even if you do get the card, say you have it after your first year, you can call and ask them, hey, if they'll lower it for your next year, because you say, hey, you know, I like the card, but the $695 annual fee is kind of killing me. Can you lower this? Can you waive this for next year? And sometimes they'll do that because, you know, this is called like getting a retention benefit, where companies, you know, they don't want to lose you because they want to, you know, every time you use that card, they make money. And if you've only had the card for like a year or so, you know, maybe they haven't made all the money back yet that they gave you in benefits. So they want to keep you. They want to keep you as a customer so they can make money from you spending money. That's the whole point. So you could try that too at the end of a year. See if they'll lower the fee for you or even waive the fee for you if you say, you know, I like the card, but I don't know if I want to keep it because of this annual fee. Now, on the gold card, you're looking at $250 annual fee. You know, relatively high as well, but I mean, it's American Express, so it's going to happen with that. And then, but also too, it says more of a card you can use day-to-day spending versus the Platinum card where it's more of a travel-focused card. So for some people, the $250 annual fee might be well worth it if they like to use it for a daily spending card and their travel card, both. Foreign transaction fee is zero on both of these. The APR for the pay over time, same, 15.99 to 22.99. Cash advance APR, 25.24% to be really specific. And the cash advance fee, same for both of these as well. 10 bucks or 5%, whichever is greater, of course. And the late payment return payment fee up to $40. Pretty standard for lots of banks, 38, 39, 40 bucks. Credit unions are going to be more likely to be, you know, 15, 20, 25, somewhere in there. But banks are going to hit you with a higher fee on that one. So with all these fees, everything in the benefits being put out there for you guys to compare side by side, go ahead and subscribe to the channel because, man, I enjoy doing these videos for you guys. I like talking credit. And if you have, like I said, one, both these cards or any experience with American Express, I would love to hear about it down below because lots of people are new to the world of credit, can feel like a very complex and overwhelming world to be in sometimes. So please do what you can to share any of your experience down in the comment section and help out the new people. I appreciate you guys watching. I appreciate you being so awesome. That is it for this video. And until next time, keep growing your money.